Hello everyone. Today the team Adesh, me and Saurav, I'm Akshya, are going to present our project on how we are going to increase the endurance of our HALE UAV, which we have designed over here, and reduce its flutter by reducing its flutter and drag. So yeah, please join us on this journey.
These are the contents which we have figured out, and we are going to follow these contents. Basically, in this project, we are going to tackle the problem of flutter, which this is a nomenclature which will be followed in our presentation. So, to quickly introduce what is flutter. So, flutter is basically a problem which is caused due to fluid structure interaction. So due to flutter, the wing structures tend to structural deformation and causes instability due to aerodynamic forces. This is due to the long aspect ratio of the wing. So this slide shows characterization of flutter. So the problem definition is that these days, UAVs like HALE UAV, which is used for military missions, have long aspect ratio, which tend to cause a flutter. And due to this flutter, there is a huge instability. So to resolve this problem, we are going to follow a certain working methodology. So our working methodology is we are going to design a wing in CATIA. And later we are going to analyze its aerodynamic performance under given flight condition. So the ANSYS software will be used for analysis of structural and numerical, and then the validation will be done using MATLAB.
Hello everyone, Saurav here. Talking about the mission profile of a UAV. So a UAV begins being, then goes up to a maximum altitude, where they perform certain operations, and then after a few hours, they go down to descent and then land at the airbase from where they took off, or maybe at another airbase. So that's we need to monitor the overall weight, like fuel weight, payload weight, and all those things, and also we need to select particular engines for the UAV. When we compare it with other classes of UAV, we need a particular engine for the UAV. And a wing has been designed so that the overall lift to be generated for the UAV to take off is generated. Like enough lift is generated for the flight to happen. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. Yeah. We have selected an airfoil which we feel is capable of generating enough lift. And the one we have selected is NACA 23015. So now we know that there are three different series of NACA F. One is 4-digit, 5-digit, and the 6-digit series. So that is a wing design and the UAV data. We have designed the wing on CATIA, and this is how it will look from different angles.
Okay, and these are the scaling calculations of a model that we have done with a ratio of 1:100.
And these are the dimensions of the wing. So the overall length is 37.55 feet. Wing aspect ratio, swept wing, that is 20, and for unswept, that is 22.5. Then the LE sweep is 22, backward span is 84.14 feet. LE for the unsweep is 2 and the span is 91.39 feet, and the wheelbase is 5,500 nanometers. कौन बोलेगा बाय द वे
आदेश
सो दिस इज द मास वेट एंड परफॉर्मेंस पैरामीटर्स व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू फॉलो इन आवर प्रोजेक्ट नेक्स्ट सो द फ्लो चार्ट फॉर मॉडलिंग एंड एनालिसिस स्टार्ट्स विद कैटिया मॉडलिंग देन इन एंसिस वर्क बेंच वी आर मेशिंग आवर विंग देन यूजिंग एंसिस fluid flow analysis to find air load distribution for both swept and unswept wing has been done. Under ANSYS mechanical, we are doing structural meshing, static structural analysis to find stress value. Then we are doing modal analysis, modal 1 to modal 3. Then for final validation, we are using MATLAB. So in macros, selection of airfoil plays a vital role in HALE UAV design configuration because of morphing wing. So here in CATIA, three-dimensional interactive application and commercial software developed by Dassault Systems and C++ programming language. CATIA has been used for our major designing thing, and ANSYS Workbench will be doing all the analysis part.
So we have actually modeled our morphing wing of our HALE UAV using CATIA over here. And we have also meshed it so that we could perform our CFD and static structural analysis to understand the fluid structure interaction and also how the forces are going to act and where. This is another view of our same morphing wing that we have modeled. This is the post-meshing view of our morphing wing. And this is when we have refined our morphing wing meshing further in order to increase the accuracy of our results.
So for analysis, we then use the .IGES file and we import it to ANSYS Workbench. Now we do the following on ANSYS Workbench. This is ANSYS Meshing, ANSYS Fluent, and ANSYS Mechanical. Now going to ANSYS CFD Meshing, we do a meshing and then a domain is created in the ICEM CFD. And then in the next figure, we'll show you how we can show how the fluid is flowing over the semi-wing at a certain angle of, I mean, certain velocity from leading to trailing edge. Fine mesh for the wing's edge face will also lead to good quality mesh, which leads to a better result. Now, the fluent analysis. The model is transported to fluent for fluid flow analysis, and we find the certain boundary, we use a certain boundary condition as given below. So velocity 68 meters per second, temperature 300 Kelvin, pressure one bar, and density 1.225 kilometers kg per meter cube. And the pressure load is shown in the next slide.
So this slide shows the static structural analysis which we have done. So for maximum, it is 0.0017119, where the red area shows the maximum static force. And the blue area shows the minimum. So these are the parameters for structural analysis which we are obtaining. So the meshing is generated for UAV wing components such as skin, strings, etc. So the parameters are mentioned below. So basically, this is the resulting analysis slide. So in this slide, we are discussing results for static structural. A classic static structural analysis was performed. The results shown was the maximum at chord of around 20.82 megapascal and the minimum of 2.3138 megapascal. So the slide shows all the detailed analysis of static structure. Next slide, please. So here you can observe that near the, like in the right side of wing, we are obtaining maximum structural stress. It is due to why the it is due to the wing which is connected to fuselage. So that is the reason why we are getting maximum stress there.
So anyway, this is one missus stresses that we have considered. The other forms of stresses as well, but the common one is one missus stress.
So we are obtaining deformation results here. Deformation of wing is more at the end of the tip. The deformation value is 1.885 mm for unswept wing and 14.6648 for swept wing, as indicated in both the figures below.
So here are the model results. So model results basically give us an idea of how much which part of a wing vibrates. So you see the blue region over there, that's the one which is attached to the fuselage, and that's the part which that gets dampened due to the presence of a heavy structure, that's the fuselage. But the other end, that's the reddish area and the other colors next to it, those areas are free moving structures. So there's a free ends. So now free ends are subject to heavy vibrations, and we see that the red ones are the areas of high vibrations, and that high vibrations actually causes physical deformity over there, and that's why these areas are most subject to they can easily be broken up due to the high vibrations. That's the physical damage, and we have done two more such analysis. Here's the other one, and the next one. So you see, by doing certain changes, how much we can reduce the amount of vibrations. So you see, the first picture had a greater red area, like there was a larger red area of red, and here it's a bit less. That's how morphing can reduce the amount of flutter in the whole wing, and thus reducing any physical damages that can cause any accidents in flight. Therefore, we can conclude from this project that a morphing wing a morphing wing for a high aspect ratio and high lift to drag ratio, it will significantly reduce the fluttering in the wing, and thus that significantly reduces the physical damage that can be caused to a wing.
Okay, so this is how we have plotted a displacement versus time graph in order to analyze ISCA oscillations and its flutter. So you see initially it's high and it damps due to air friction and other aspects of it. And with morphing wing, we can damp it even further. Now the scope of future work is, first of all, we have to focus on its materials. Composite materials are used so that it can make even more lightweight, more payload. Carrying capacity of the UAV to carry payload will increase, and also we have to use the ribs and spars in such a manner that we can increase its stiffness. These are certain references that we have used to make our project. The one such was we used a lot of research papers. Use the ribs and spars in such a manner that we can increase its stiffness. These are certain references that we have used to make our project. The one such was we used a lot of research papers dealing with parametric design. Now, ending our project on the conclusion end, we have designed our UAV, and this is how it's going to look. And we have plans in our scope of future work itself that we can fuse the UAV and make it somewhere in this shape, which is a bit elliptical, because in this way, my drag is going to reduce. That is why rockets also have elliptical fins. And I'm going to fuse my wings and make it morphing. So we have done an airfoil analysis also, where how we can also introduce flaps and decrease the drag. So this would come under our further studies. Thank you.